Hello everyone, my name is General Fancy Pants, and welcome back to The Swapper. When we last left off, we're in the Planet Survey area. It's been a while since I played this game, so I can't remember where I'm going exactly, but we do have these three rooms to explore, and we have a memory terminal up there. So I guess let's start down here. There was a time long ago when the chain was full and fruitful. Then the minds like yours joined, and the rest fell silent. Huh. I don't know exactly what that means, but either way, we have a puzzle here to solve. Okay. I can't. Whoops. Alright. We can't make a swapper here, but we can switch to him, but we can make a swapper in that light, I think. If I can do it just right. Nope. So it looks like it might be one of those things where... Let's see. We won't be able to switch to him once we're up there because of this red beam here. Are there any other switches or anything? They're not. And I think this light actually... Oh, nope, okay. I thought that light maybe canceled out my clones, but I guess not. Let's see. Where can we even make a clone? Let's try something here. Alright, so now we have a clone up there. We can swap to him with the blue light. That wasn't so hard. Okay, cool. I don't know if that's, again, I don't know if that's the right way of doing things, but...
When we first discovered them on Corrie, we thought the Watchers were dumb slabs of rock. It took years of study to accept that they were alive. Not like we are, of course. They have no physical senses, no moving parts. Still, I find it hard not to wonder, can an electrical impulse in a rock really be considered a thought?
I don't know. And I just died. Let's see, where do I want to go? Alright, let's go get this memory terminal. Log number 9, Planet Corrie 5 Overview. Class Desert Uninhabitable. Research interest: abundant natural mineral deposits. Space Station Theseus in orbit since 201 years. Notable discoveries include a more durable steel amalgam and an alien life form similar to an Earth silkworm. Primary research in recent years has been focused on what have been come to be termed the Watchers, highly complex rock formations of unknown origin. Analysis of the samples on board Theseus has revealed unusual electrochemical activity within the structures, which may suggest something resembling rudimentary intelligence. Okay, so this whole thing, I think, I mean, so far, obviously, has been about these rocks and their ability to... communicate, and holy cow, this puzzle looks complicated. Okay. But their ability to communicate with, and how it seems to be kind of impossible that they're able to do that because it's a rock and they don't know if it's a real life form or if it's, what is it? So anyway, let's see, we're gonna need a person way up there. So if I can get a person up here without losing... There we go. Okay, that's actually what works. Now, don't care about that light switch anymore. And we have someone there, so actually let's get rid of those two now. We can get rid of that guy. Alright, so now we have plenty of clones to work out the rest of this. So you basically just make a clone here, make a clone right there, and swap to him. Not too bad. Yeah, so like I said, this is kind of interesting how the game has puzzle elements. I like the puzzle elements of the game, but then it kind of delves into what are these rock life forms and what's really going on in the space station, things like that. So it's more than just solving puzzles to get off the space station. There's actually more to it than that. Alright, so what did this switch do? Okay. I can make a clone right there. Because we eventually want to make a clone that can get there over to this switch, but given the placement of this button and that button, we have to have someone way over here. Right there, right where my little targeting is. And then we'll need eventually someone right there too, but let's put someone right there, swap to him. Sorry, clone, you're gonna have to go. Now, put someone up there. Oop. Crap. Alright, there's nothing I could do. Darn it. Okay, let's try that again. Clone. Right. Come on, clone. Clone. There you go. Clone right there. Clone right there. Swap to him. Clone right there. Alright, now let's see what happens when you run. Alright. Again, that wasn't so bad. I think there's 120-something orbs in this game. I think something like that. There's a lot of them. But let's head down to here now that we have that enough orbs to open up this right here, this obstacle. We've actually explored a pretty fair amount of the space station. It's actually... we're actually making some progress here, so. Alright, so that took care of the planetary survey area. I'm gonna get to this area right here. It looks like. Oh, looks like there's a lot of.
Good. The only access to Mindsai now is via gravity control. From where you are, you should be able to access an airlock. You're going to have to take a spacewalk across the station exterior.
Okay, that sounds fun. What is thought? I think I know. It must have rules. We may not see the. Nomina? I don't know what that word is. Nomina? But we surely know where they are, the cause of the thoughts. Okay. Sorry, I kind of butchered that sentence, but I didn't know that word and kind of tongue twisted me. Some of us have grown crazy. Everything there is thought. Okay, that doesn't sound good. Alright, so we've got three hatches here, and a teleport machine and a memory terminal, but I think I will take care of this section in the next episode. So, I will see you guys next time on the Swapper when we go through high security laboratories. Until then.